This is NORLA. One winner and many losers. This is more than just a race. It's a battle for something big. Oh yeah, we're ready.
I'm American made. My mama taught me wrong from right. I was born in the South. Sometimes I have a big mouth when I see something that I don't like. I gotta say it.
Hello and welcome everyone here to the Texas Motor Speedway for the NORLA Cup Series race here under the lights at Texas. Cody Goforth captured the pole for tonight's race. Dylan Abrahamian will be to his outside. The playoffs continue here as after this race we head out to Phoenix. A win in this race as a playoff driver guarantees you a spot in the final four. So a lot is on the line here for Texas and when we go out there for ISM. But we're going to get you down here to the track side to get this thing fired up and underway here at Texas.
Drivers, start your engines.
And you hear the engines firing up down there on pit road. Drivers rolling off the grid led by Cody Goforth. So coming into the round here, eight drivers left in the playoffs, but only four obviously can move on to the final four. Juan Garcia, after last round at Talladega, he did have the points lead here in the playoffs, but they failed post-race inspection. No points for them. So that would make Fitzwater the points leader with 4,013 points. And there's Jonathan Lawson, the rookie, with 4,009 points, and Cody Goforth with 4,006 points. Nick Smith has 4,005 points. Jesse Turner, Jay Jefferson, and James Bowles, no points for them. They'll be looking to score some major points here tonight in hopes to make Phoenix a bit easier for them. There's Fitzwater right there. Won this race last season, by the way, to lock himself into the Final Four, which ultimately led to him winning the championship. Can Fitzwater do it again? There's Dylan Young in the 33. And right in front of him, that was the 11 of Jacob Hollitz behind him. Halt's teammate William Brock, also really good here at Texas. You see the four of Nick Smith as well.
Get ready to go here, buddy.
Pace car. Garcia, there he is. A lot of making up to do for those guys without points. But here we go. Pace car all the way down pit road. And it's going to be the 37 of Cody Goforth, leading the field of Queen as the playoffs continue here in NORLA from Texas. Coming around to lead lap number one out of corner number four. It's going to be the 37 of Cody Goforth. And how about Mac Johnson in the 23 second, but he's under fire from the 7 now. As a 2 did not get such a good start to the race. Dylan Abrahamian already falling back to the outside, maybe potentially out of the top 10. You see last time by 8th place. So a really bad start for that 2. Now for second, your Coke 600 winner, Roger James, to the inside. Out of fourth, Goforth continues to lead. Oh, car in the grass. That was Fitzwater nearly getting turned by the 19 off Tim Randolph. Close call right there, but Fitzwater able to regroup. And the 19 still all rollovers back bumper. I don't think that's where you want to be, as Fitzwater's not one of those guys you really want to take off on the track. The defending champion is back to the inside of 23 of Mac Johnson, looking now underneath the 7. As what a great job this young driver's been doing, Mac Johnson. Up to second right here. He's only started a handful of races right before the playoffs at Homestead, replacing Tyson Gifford, and he has ran such good races. That team has really fast cars, and their young driver is definitely putting on a show for them. As Athens currently in the back right here, 3 wide. There's a 41, Garcia. As I mentioned, disqualified after Talladega, there's a 4. NORLA has been cracking down on penalties. NORLA is not kidding here, especially in the playoffs.
Still out there.
As you go on board with Nick Smith from the 4.
Outside. Outside.
Smith making up some...
Pretty wide outside.
Making up some grounds pretty early on here as he goes 3 wide with some other drivers. Goforth continues to lead. These two young drivers continue to go side by side. Roger James and 23 of Mac Johnson. Couple playoff teammates right there. Fitzwater Australia Racing still got the 34 and the 38. Hunting for a championship. Fitzwater going for his second straight championship. But I'm sure if he doesn't win it, he wants his young driver, Jonathan Lawson, to win it. That will give the team back-to-back championships here in the Cup. 3 wide right here. Christian Russell in 77, 11 on the inside, or in the middle line, rather. Texas, one of those tracks, not easy to run here. At the Texas Motor Speedway, see Sam Adoskin, former winner here at Texas, as he gets kicked up to the outside in that 9 car. Now Nick Smith, he has made up a ton of positions already on the inside, getting a big push by the 53 of Seth Hayes. Seth Hayes, though, going to try and make a move on Nick Smith. Nevins to the inside of the 78 of Cam Cole. 48 of Jefferson, he's going to go to the inside of Nevins. Jefferson now trying to follow the 26. Remember, Jefferson was one of those many drivers that had problems over the weekend with tech and unapproved adjustments. Was unapproved adjustments for the 48. Other guys like Christian Russell had an engine change. Failed tech for Marcus Epez. Unapproved adjustments for Seth Hayes. Vargas with the crash in quality. And another failed tech for Joe Jefferson in 14. Sure on board the helmet cam here of Jesse Turner at 43. Your Charlotte Rover winner. Currently under fire from the 12 of Shaw, Khan Shaw's FAR teammates. Dylan Young side by side with the 5 of Zayden Davidson. We head back up to the front. Henley having a pretty strong run right here in the top 10 as he tries to go underneath the 20 of Max Anderson. Behind them, Tim Randolph, 23, just ahead of them, still holding that 4th position. Of that's Mac Johnson as Randolph now to the inside of that 52. James still running second. James Bowles has found his way to third. That's Roger James ahead of him. And Cody Goforth continues to lead. Goforth, always one of those guys who's really strong in the playoffs. Won the Xfinity race out there at Bristol to move on to the next round. And he's won quite a few races this race, or this season as well. Goforth moving over to the 48 next season to drive for Horizon Motorsports. Sam Adoskin, he has fallen way to the back here. As I mentioned, a former winner here at Texas. Seth Cutler is back here as well. Just ahead of him, James Allison in the 24. He's right on board here, the 47.
Inside.
He's going to have Jacob Athens and Sam Adoskin to his inside.
Still there.
Coming around to complete 12 laps here on the green, so we may see some green flag pit stops here. At Texas, Marcus Epez, he's running right there behind the 41 of Garcia, who's looking for points here. Really good points day, especially after Dega. Chad Myers side by side with the 21 of Trevor Collins. Ahead of them, Cameron Brantley side by side with the 14. Ahead of them, Brandon Smith. As Carpentier moves to the inside of William Brock, still can't believe Brock has yet to win this season in that 18 machine. I don't know what is going on, but they're usually a driver that's a winner, and they have yet to win anything this season. Well, besides the season opener, the shootout, but other than that, no wins for Brock. as we see Nick Smith here working on trying to get around that 38. Nick Smith is continuing to gain ground.
Take it easy on your tires. Cool those jokers off a little bit.
Throughout this race here early on. Smith already has multiple wins this season, trying to make it all the way to the Final Four, going for his first championship here in the Cup Series. Seth Hayes right there gets a bit loose underneath the, or behind the 12 rather. Jesse Turner trying to work on maybe getting back around the 12. Here he comes, a crossover move to the inside. And pit stop, so here we go. Green flag pit stop starting here. Turner's going to be one of those couple, we got a car wrecking! We got multiple cars wrecking, entering pit road. Nick Smith, one of them. The 99 is around. A huge mess going down pit road. One car destroyed up there on the track. They're stopped. Caution flag is going to be out. As all those guys go down pit road when it's closed, though. Caution flag is out. A huge wreck going down pit road. Carpentier with some damage. Oh, we got a car going upside down in the pits. That's the 18 of William Brock. William Brock in the 18 is on his freaking roof on pit road. And then now he retires to his box. A really sharp turn of events here at Texas. And we saw, I believe that's the 11 car also, heavily damaged on pit road. All right, so the shenanigans have started here as we had a pile up going down pit road. That is not something you usually see, especially here at Texas. Here's a 36 of Christian Vargas. He is destroyed. They're going to try and keep it out there. They're going to put on some tires and probably take off the hood on that thing. There's a 19 of Randolph. The 1 of Chad Myers. He is completely destroyed. Oh man, the 78 of Cam Cole as well. I really want to see what happened here. Camera's on Fitzwater. Oh, he did not check up. Ran into the back of the 11. Oh my goodness. Then look at the 8 of Brandon Smith. Vargas, a heavy hit. Getting into the 77 of Christian Russell. That was a big hit. Fitzwater, he just did not check up in time. There was a lot of guys. Look how many guys are going down pit road too. So pit road stacked up. I don't know why everyone is pitting at, or nearly everyone pitting at the same time. Fitzwater took a big hit to that outside wall. Russell getting up. All four wheels look like they came off the ground right there. That was a big hit because Fitzwater and someone else went back out on the track.
Leaders on pit road.
Someone got into them riding on board with Fitz. Yeah, I didn't think he expected those guys in front to slow up so much, and he just gets hammered right there. And Fitzwater doesn't look like he's going to win another Texas race. On board here without time. James Ellison.
Stay high. Up on you.
Wow, absolutely nowhere to go. Right into the driver's door. 41.
They might as well park it.
As we saw the 41 keep going, though. That was a really heavy hit. On board with Smith.
Leaders off the road. Back in front of you.
Yeah, nowhere for Smith to go. Such a very strange crash. A bunch of guys was going on pit road, and then some guys just didn't expect as many people to go down pit road. And a lot of guys did not check up like everyone else. So you're going to see these first couple guys here. It's going to start with, I believe, the 11. Going to wait for Bahaltz to come in the picture here. Oh, no. You see, yeah, the 77 of Christian Russell getting hit by the 11, but Fitzwater came and ran into him, and you didn't see the 8 was staying out as well as the 36, and you see the 41. All those guys were staying out. The wreck just happened right in front of them. So some really big hits right there. Look at Garcia. Now look at the 24 of James Ellison. He too was staying out, and then of course nobody expecting this, and he couldn't slow down in time. It's been a rough couple races here for James Ellison, but caution flag is out here at Texas. We'll be back. Welcome back here to the Texas Motor Speedway, getting set to go back green after a huge wreck started with drivers trying to go down pit road, but too many at the same times, and a lot of spotters seem to have been confused as to when to pit, but a lot of teams came down at the same time. That's really what triggered that mess. A lot of guys did not get checked up in time. You can see all the lappers down there on the inside. this thing might get a bit wild here for this restart, so we're lining them up and we're gonna see what happens here. First restart of the night.
Car's gone. Stay ready.
Here at the Texas Motor Speedway, getting set to go back green here. And there we go. Green flag is back out at Texas. Everyone's going to be fanning out, scattering, trying to find out where to go, which room to go. If that makes any sense. Oh, nearly a bit of contact between the 2 and 47 right there. The 11, obviously. Jacob Hall's going to be really slow. He's going to hold up Seth Cutler. That outside line, Tim Randolph goes around on the back stretch. In the corner three, back up and gets the 4 of Nick Smith. Caution flag is out. Nick Smith, another playoff driver collected. That's the 16 of James Bowles.
Go straight to the garage. Straight to the garage, guys. Meet him down to the garage.
And Nick Smith's night is done here at Texas. Holy cow, another wreck here. Caution's gonna be out. A couple guys got their laps back, it looks like, maybe. But caution flag is gonna be out again. Seth Hayes scored as your race leader. We saw the 19 getting turned off, I believe the nose of the 23. We're gonna see what oh man, he went down trying to get around a slower double zero, but the 23 was there. So definitely not Mac Johnson's fault. It's just that I don't think the 19 realized that the 23 was coming up really quickly and then causes the wreck. Nick Smith gets sent into the crash after hitting the 19. Heavy impacts to that outside wall. Smith's night is done here, the 19 as well. You see it right there, moves over, got into Mac Johnson. They probably both would have smacked that inside wall had a 17 not been there, but 17 also gets collected. Jesse Turner, I see him in the mix as well. So Turner, see him go for a spin. He's going to hit the outside wall in that blue number 43. So three playoff drivers in one incident here. You can see Turner running right in front of the 48. Season 19 gets turned, but the 17 came right back up on the track. That's Mark Desacci. And Turner getting into the 42 right there. And this brings out our second yellow of the night. Multiple playoff drivers collected. And this is sweet music to all the other playoff drivers' ears. Running on board here.
Easy record.
With Nick Smith, he took a hard hit from the 19.
Okay, go straight to the garage. Straight to the garage, guys. Get him down to the garage.
Communications right there. Running on board here with James Bowles. That's in the 16.
He's there.
He had no idea that was coming right there. Really hard hit. And man, Dylan Young, he also gets collected. Heavy damage. He's done and out of contention. But wrecks continue here at Texas. We're going to take a quick break, though, and we'll be back. Welcome back here to the Texas Motor Speedway. Under the lights, the playoffs continue here in the Cup Series. Two more races to go after this one. We head to Phoenix to battle out in the desert. The final chance at the Final Four here in the Cup Series. All three series will be out there. And then finally, we head to Chicagoland for the finale to crown a new champion for the NORLA Cup Series. NORLA going through a bit of a name change for the next year. Changing it to NORLA Motorsports. We have a bunch of series running all at the same time. It's going to be chaos, but it's going to be fun. After that, not sure what the future holds for NORLA, but we'll cross the bridge when we get there as the pace car pulls off. Getting set to go back green here. And a ton of playoff or a ton of lap drivers to deal with as the 53 scored as a race leader. We're green racing again at Texas. And again, everybody is going to be scattering, trying to get around those slower cars. The 62 is the one that's slow now. That's Dallas Carpentier just ahead of 23 or the 53 right there. Scoforth moves to the inside. Brock moves to the inside of him for three wide. Brock looked like he's going to get past the 62 just okay right there. They're still three wide behind him, though, out of corner exit number 4. Out front, it's a 22 that time by. 21's a lap down, but the 22 of Alexander Rowe. We do apologize about that skip right there, but 22 of Alexander Rowe out front. And right behind him, a 48 of Jefferson. There's Nevins. He's also racing up here. He would love to get his second win on the season. Bunch of wounded guys. You see the 96 of Martin. There's a 16 of James Bowles. He's still in this race here, hoping for something to happen to the other playoff drivers. Texas, a very different track from in the past, especially corners 3 and 4, or I guess you should say 1 and 2, right? Two Dylan Ebrahimian right there racing side by side with the 9. Sam Adoskin has found himself in the top 10, but he's getting freight trained currently by that bottom groove. Mac Johnson, one of those drivers down there, he's going to try and make a pass on the 2 of Dylan Ebrahimian. Don't quite have the run to do it just yet right there, as Malik Nevins has taken the race lead here at Texas. Driver 4 Flying Racing. And that team has found some true speed here late in the season, especially that 10 team. One out there at Old Spice ran really well, showed some really good speed races after that, but they've got caught up in all the drivers' messes as well. There's a 33 of Dylan Young. I can't believe that thing is still out there running. But they're still back up there. They've reached tops or a minimum speed, I guess you could say, along with Luke Martin and other damaged guys like the 11 of Jacob Bahals. It's been a rough couple of races for Bahals as well here in the Cup Series. He's still going, though, for a championship over there on the Xfinity side of things. 13 laps to go, coming to 12 to go when they cross the line this time by here at Texas. Field is a bit spread out. Things have calmed down, maybe just a little bit. And if we do have to go green all the way, the rest of the way, there should be more green flag pit stops. And that didn't work the first time around. So we'll see how that fares out the second time around here at Texas. And another thing to think about too, with all those wounded guys back there, lap cars may be a factor here late race. As they run right now, Cody Goforth, the highest running playoff driver, probably about second. Those two drivers, 21 and 47 a lap down. But Goforth, and they're going to go down pit road now. So here we go, green flag pit stops. Anyone else going to join them? And see right there, spotters made sure to tell them this time as to wait a lap after everyone else, if that makes sense. But kind of splitting up the field in two here. That's what they should have done the first time instead of having everybody come down all at once. As you see the 48 there on pit road. Cody Goforth, he's also on pit road. Nevins, he's getting some right side tires.
10 laps to go this time by. Nice and smooth.
As that time by, the 18 is your race leader. There's Henley in the 52. Currently scored second. The 19 third. The 12 fourth. Mac Johnson scored in the top 5 right now. There's William Brock in the 18. Just ahead of the 99, who's not on the lead lap, as we should see Brock come in this time, as here he comes with the 21 of Trevor Collins. And will anyone else follow them down pit road? So far, no. A couple other guys on pit road. So this is the final stop of the night, so we really don't want to mess this up. We could still get a yellow and maybe get a restart. There's a lot is on the line here tonight, especially for playoff drivers. And as they run right now, we have 0 playoff drivers in the top 10. 99 peels off down a pit road. We'll see what happens where these playoff drivers line up after pit stops have cycled through. Here's Malik Nevins. He's already back out there, so he should cycle to the race lead. But we'll see if anyone else had a quicker pit stop than Nevins. Look at our spectator cam here. The side-by-side battle of 19 and the 12. Currently running 1 and 2. They stay out. Well, when will they come down a pit road? That should be answered rather quickly. I'm just shocked right now, though, that Tim Randolph in that 19 with a heavily damaged race car. Look at the back of that thing. Running right here right now, third place. Trying to stretch it as much as they can here on fuel. These guys probably hoping for yellow. The 12 is going to come in now along with the 52. A couple other guys back there is going to follow. The 7 is on pit road. Tim Randolph, Watkins Glen winner, two-time champion of the series. Looking to go to victory lane for the second time this season. How about the 23, Matt Johnson, as I've Manchin has been really impressive. Diego Yepez currently runs third. There's Nevins right there. More drivers coming down pit road. So here comes the leaders now down pit road. And I believe Nevins is going to cycle back to the race lead here. There he is running between two lappers. Seth Cutler behind him. In front of him, that's the 99 of Jacob Athens, Bristol winner. Nevins trying to look for a way underneath the 99. Can't get by that time. May have a big run here out of two. Nevins to the inside. And there's the 12. Actually, Shaw in the 12 may take the lead from Nevins here. So Shaw comes out right in front of Nevins. What a pit stop by the 12 of Shaw. But here comes Nevins, though. His tires is already heated up. Battle for the race lead here at Texas. And possibly for the race win. Shaw and Nevins both stuck racing with guys who are left. Oh, contact! Seth Cutler into Malik Nevins, hard into the inside wall. This is going to bring out the caution. Seth Cutler turns Malik Nevins. And this may just end the race here as Tim Randolph, well, he was scored as the leader last time. No, Tim Randolph is not the leader. It's Shaw in the 12. The Austin Motorsports car scored out front here. Caution flag is out. That may have just ended the race. And Shaw looking at a potential first career win here. Three is on pit road. Oh, three is heavily damaged. Oh, James Bowles and Nevins. N23, what happened? As we're looking back at the initial yellow right here, the 47 goes up the track, gets into Nevins. Nevins slams the inside wall. And man, this is what I'm talking about. They have speed, but keeps getting taken out by other drivers. And Seth Cutler maybe trying to side draft right there. Rookie mistake getting into Nevins. And now we saw the 23 and some other drivers damage. And man, Mac Johnson, nowhere to go. I wonder if it's oil on the track or all that smoke, couldn't see anything. We saw James Bowles with damage. I don't know where that came from. Oh man, the three. Kevin Brantley gets into Mac Johnson. Mac Johnson was having such a good day. Oh, Brantley also goes upside down. Bowles hits him in the door, and then Bowles himself gets hit in the door by Logan York. Christian Russell barely able to squeak on by. And that puts the three of Kevin Brantley up and over. Another look at it here. Out of corner four there. Seth Cutler is a lap car. He should not be racing these leaders. And that's just something you're gonna have to learn here, with especially at the end of these races, just let the leaders race. And that's not something that happened. And you see what it did right there. Nevins is not gonna be happy. Yeah, Mac Johnson's coming through the smoke. He didn't even see Nevins down there. And there could be oil on the track as well for Johnson. Feel it for him. He was having such a nice day in that beats Toyota. And then gets hit right there. You see by the three of Kevin Brantley. Brantley, one of those drivers who really wants to get a win before the season is done here. And then James Bowles right into the side of Kevin Brantley here, but really slow, about 56 or so miles an hour. So not a hard hit to the driver's door, but still that puts the three upside down. And Bowles himself gets in the door by Logan York, who is going just over, what, 50, 70 maybe? And a race ending caution, I do believe, riding on board here with Mac Johnson.
Caution. Slow car off to the right. Stay on your toes.
Oh man, he just clips the left front of Nevins right there. I thought you'd expect Nevins to keep going up the track, but that wasn't the case. And then the three comes in. James Bowles, double zero. All collected here in this incident. But wow. Late race wreck here is going to end the race under yellow. And first career win. First win for Austin Motorsports this season. First career win for Shaw is looming here, as long as they don't blow up and go down pit road or anything like that. Second place is scored as a 48. And the 12 is not signaling down pit road. So once again, another first time winner this season. We didn't have one at Dega. We had Austin win Dega, but we had the 99 win Bristol. But Shaw, first career win for pretty Shaw.
Next
year, Texas. Once again, a non-playoff driver upsetting the field with a win here. Shaw brings it home first, Jefferson second, Tim Randolph third, Justin Henley fourth, and Seth Hayes. How about Henley and Hayes? Fourth and fifth for that team. Really good results for them. Diego Yepez, Cody Goforth, looks like he is, well, him and Jay Jefferson, only playoff drivers. Alexander Rowe, Crown Jr., and Roger James running out your top 10 here at Texas. 22 drivers was on the lead lap, three of them a lap down, everyone else wrecked out. But what a crazy ending here to the race at Texas. Caution ends the race. James Ellison, a tough night for him. The young driver just trying to gain more experience for next season. Juan Garcia, no points for him. Fitzwater also right there, but he has some points to lean on, as well as Lawson and Smith. And Jesse Turner, no points for them. First career win, though, for Shaw in the 12. Austin Motorsports, man, it's crazy because Sam Austin won the last race at Talladega, and his team wins here at Texas. But, well-deserved win for Shaw. It's been a long time coming, and they've had a bunch of, a few rough patches along the way that led up to this. They've had some really good speed this season, ran really well a couple races, and finally just kind of pierced through that veil here tonight and won it here at Texas. But that's going to be it here from Texas. The playoffs continues, though. Next race at Phoenix, the trucks, the Xfinity and Cup will all be out there battling in the desert. And then, of course, on to Chicagoland as we finish up the season here in NORLA Cup Series. Thank you guys, as always, to watch as they go through spoiling lug nuts check right there on pit road. And we'll see you for the truck race out there at ISM. And good night, everybody. Hope you guys enjoyed your weekend and have a safe week. And we'll see you for the next race at ISM. And not stating that it's going to be a week till I upload, I'll try to get it up as quickly as possible. Thank you guys for watching, and it's on to the next one.